Drake goes off first blood with a snap there, just trying to keep him into the air so he can hit a shadow flare to 48%. When you're fighting a Terry, there's the pinnacle of frame three option into 26 damage. Back air gonna do it right there. No wing, 80%, like not even at the ledge. So maybe some bad DI from Mega. Mega definitely just content to play slow now that he has a lead. Try to keep this Terry in this game. Okay, I said he was gonna play slow, but he's out for blood. He's trying to make a statement here. Down air is gonna be enough to take it on the Terry. So. Three stocks to one. Sephiroth hasn't even gotten wing yet, so Mega's definitely sitting pretty here. He's gonna have a lot of opportunities to just play carefully and see what happens. But yeah, 64% on Rango already. Yeah, Rango occasionally comes to the monthly. It's been a while though. Yeah, so Omega still not having wing at 100%. That just goes to show how far ahead he is. Kind of gotta keep him safe there at the ledge. Down tilt, God, I always forget, burning knuckle enough to take it though, so. As soon as Omega gets wing, he immediately dies. But he's still two stocks to one here. Terry has go, so. And Sephiroth is very light. So Omega definitely has to be careful here, but he's definitely sitting comfortably right now at the lead. Just has to avoid any ghosts in there. And back there gonna be enough to take it there. So game one, go to Omega, very dominant fashion. Sephiroth Cloud. Rango definitely going for the counter pick here.
The Terry was not working, and don't actually know how this matchup goes. I feel like it's Cloud favored just from Sephiroth's weaknesses being kind of just characters that can stay in his face and have the speed to get in on him. Cloud's going to do that and has a big sword, but so far Omega's still showing that Cloud's not enough to put any fear in him. He's looking to stab this Cloud through the chest. Hang him on a sword for a little while. Yeah, so forward air, gonna throw him off stage, and he is forced to burn limit here and still can't get back to ledge. Then Sephiroth down air, gonna take it. Yeah, Omega's definitely just like playing really solid this set, definitely out for blood. So Mango is looking to try to answer back. Aggressive forward smash on a character like Sephiroth at the ledge that might have killed. So. Just swinging for defenses, trying to even this out. They get fair into up air, so getting out of percent where he's just going to be able to kill him naturally anyway. You got void, combo starts from Sephiroth. So then you end up in a situation where it has to blow limit again just to recover. So he's content to just charge it instead of go for the ledge trap on a character like Sephiroth. But again, just off stage, and Omega going to call out the jump. Limit blade or limit climb hazard not gonna be enough. That F tilt angle just is absolutely disgusting. Omega looking to be kind of smooth with it on that slide, but Omega just doesn't really have an answer for this Sephiroth. Just might be a little bit of matchup experience, and might just be how well Omega's playing today. And you're going to get hit by the toenail. Or the very last splotch of ink for limit, and it's going to be enough to send him flying, but not enough to kill him. That's still going to take it, but 95% and two stocks to take off. Like Mango is definitely going to, it's doable, but it's definitely going to be a rough situation, especially if he just keeps getting like kept off
kept in the corner and not able to just play on stage. Go punish the counter with a cross slash there. Parry on the forward air. And Etil gonna do it at the ledge there, so 2-0 Omega. Yeah, like I thought, Rango's saying he's never played Sephiroth, but it's like good.